I'm 60 years old now. My professional career began about age 27, I think. I've been an unviolent, all-out warrior, first in industry and now for humanity, my entire adult life. In high stakes, high risk, failure is not an option situations. There are a few things that I know, but I know that. I don't play in situations where I can't win. I don't play in situations where everyone else says we can't win. For 4 years now, my entire being has been gripped by the horror of impending climate Armageddon. I've been moving in the direction of understanding how to stop it, but at the same time knowing I didn't. And not having really a prayer of seeing how to stop it. But 3 weeks ago, that prayer was before my eyes. It happened, among other things, after watching the movie Tipping Point. If you Google Tracking Plan B, that will take you to one of my two major sites, and you'll see a link to that video on YouTube, Tracking Plan B, an hour and a half. It's a must-see. Even though I've been studying nothing but 7 days a week, the impending climate Armageddon, that movie showed me something that I hadn't seen clearly enough. The rank insanity, the clear clinical insanity that in Canada's case, $2 trillion in expected revenue generates among otherwise presumably sane, humane people. Aggressively killing their Native Americans so they don't get in the way of their indigenous, so they don't get in the way of the tar sands. And after seeing that movie, some days later, everything else that's been working in my nervous system and my heart produced the answer I'd been looking for. There are two other movies that I saw prior to this epiphany as well, and had I not seen them, the epiphany might not have happened. Freedom Riders, both the PBS documentary and the hour special that Oprah Winfrey did, both are must-see. And Iron-Jawed Angels on the women's suffrage movement. If you Google Tracking Plan B or Google Start Loving, both my blogs come up. Look for the library tab and you'll find all of these there. After seeing those three, they brought together everything else that I've learned in my life and about climate Armageddon. And the epiphany was this. Till enough people are seen dying for it, global warming will not stop. There's a corollary to that. When enough people are seen dying for it, global warming will stop. This was euphoria for me. This was ecstatic for me. Now I know what to do. Now I know what to do. The race is on. My life is going to be one of those. Just like someone would joyfully dive on a grenade to save his buddies. Just like a woman in New York earlier this year joyfully placed her body shielding a young girl I think she didn't know when she heard gunfire on the street and her life was forfeit. Just like one of our heroic soldiers in Afghanistan saw a child in the way of a vehicle and traded his life for that child's by pushing her out of the way. Of course, I just wanted to see how to stop the deliverance of hell to hundreds of billions of people. And now I see it. And if there are 1,000 people in this country, in the U.S., that value humanity more than their own life, they will race to join this death fest, which is on day 17 here in front of the Canadian Embassy, which is the scene in back of me here. Till enough are seen dying for it, CO2 won't stop. $2 trillion in revenue expected by the Canadian government generates a whole lot of crazy. A rough estimate of $20 trillion that the fossil fuel industry, secondarily the corn ethanol industry, is expecting in revenues. $20 trillion. What do you think is going to make these people stop? Kumbaya? Email campaigns? And I posed the wrong question. What do you think is going to make them stop in time? And unless Jim Hansen is smoking something or lying to us, 6 years ago was too late. This year is our last chance. We need to reduce carbon 6% per year starting this year, or it becomes cost prohibitive to go to 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12%, which it would be 6 years from now. We need to start this year, and we absolutely can. When there are 1,000 people in front of the Canadian Embassy, using that as a backdrop, to end global warming, it will stop. It will shock the conscience of the nation. It will shock the conscience of the world. It may or may not shock a Harper, Canada's premier, out of his insanity, but it will shock enough onlookers that it will stop. Because what we're doing, condemning every young person today and everyone in the future to life on hell, is rank insanity. No one wants to do that to their children. No one wants to balance the economy on their children's back. But we are so addicted to stuff. We are so in clinical insanity, clinical addiction to stuff and the denial that goes with it, that until enough people are seen dying for it, nothing else is going to cut through that insanity. But that will, when enough are seen dying for it, global warming will stop. And 2012 is the year. We're not going to get another chance at this. If we let the tundra melt, it's game over. The thermal equivalent of, rough estimate, 30 million Hiroshima class nuclear bombs going off in the atmosphere every day, to extrapolate on Jim Hansen's work. This is the year. This is the tool. Most of us are cowards. Most of us will hide behind our proven impotent activism. Email campaigns, occasional marches, lobbying are not going to pry people away from an expected $20 trillion in revenue. When enough people are seen dying for it, that will cut through the insanity. Nothing else will. So if you want to kill time, do something else. If you want to save humanity, join the death fest.